it's very dark at this hour. It used to not be so dark at this hour. And what is going on there? It looks as though there might be problems with a wheel, which often happens in these pursuits.
So again, the top of your screen, it's always usually pretty accurate, but sometimes the way I'm maneuvering the camera.
Rolling.
Yo, what's good, fam? It's your boy Stacks Global coming back with another video. Hey, what y'all on, man? Y'all seen that? I was doing a little light skin face. That's what y'all light skin boys be doing, bro. Hey, man. Hey, a couple videos ago, bro. Y'all see my little lips a little dry and stuff. Y'all could have told them like, yo, put some chapstick on or something, bro. Like, lick your lips. Like, goddamn, bro. Y'all got me out here looking like this in front of the ladies. Y'all bugging, bro. I thought we was family, man. But it's all good, though. Nah, I'm just fucking with y'all, man. What y'all on, man? Hope y'all having a good day. Hopefully, this video can make your day better if it's not going good for you. And, yeah, if you're new to the channel, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And we gone. We gonna get right to it.
We have some breaking news we want to take you to right now. There seems to be some kind of a police pursuit. It looks as though it's coming toward an end on Monroe Road there in Winkler Drive. We have Tammy Rose above it in Sky Eye. It looks like they're in some kind of shopping center there, Tammy.
Yeah, we actually picked up the chase near the Gulf Freeway in Monroe, and they actually got off the freeway. We've got our exclusive sky map at the top of your screen. The suspect not stopping, and it looks like going at a pretty high rate of speed.
Oh, that thing hawking.
So again, if you were headed out the door, our exclusive sky map pinpointing exactly where this driver is. Gina?
Obviously, I erroneously thought it was coming to an end because I saw them slowing down, Eric, as they went through that strip center. But no, these vehicles are still in pursuit. Of course, there's a new policy in the city of Houston, at least, when it comes to police pursuits. They're trying not to be as aggressive as they used to, depending on what it is the person they're pursuing is accused of doing.
Yeah, right now they're not letting up on this one, though. And I know details are just coming in as we continue to watch this chase as they come up to a light right here that's going to be pretty congested. So,
oh, yeah, he's blowing that. There you go.
Suspect doesn't hit anybody. Made it through that light right there, but here's more traffic. Now, Tammy, so kind of watch this unfold here and watch this driver get onto the wrong side of the road here. Do we know anything about how long this has been going on or even why they were initially stopping this driver?
Yeah, we picked it up about 5 minutes, Sky Eye 13 first on scene following this chase. And we actually
Well, that
heard
thing
it
is hawking. Damn.
Helicopter telling us that they were on the Gulf Freeway inbound right around Monroe chasing this suspect again, blowing through a stop sign, a very dangerous situation. So again, if you're heading out the door, our sky map at the top of your screen, avoid the area if you can.
Yeah, we hate to. It's very dark at this hour. It used to not be so dark at this hour. And what is going on there? It looks as though there might be problems with a wheel, which often happens in these pursuits. A lot of dust seems to be kicking up. I don't know, perhaps it's just the road that they're traveling, but
yeah, we've seen this driver though go in the opposite direction and go around into lanes of oncoming traffic several times. Even the officer had to do it right there. Again, they're not letting up on this driver coming into more traffic. Of course, it's rush hour in Houston, so we all know what that is like. The driver taking a hard right there, but police staying very close to that.
And there you go.
Dodge Maroon Challenger. If we're
it's a Charger.
Get a better look at that. That's what it appears to be at this point. But this driver, of course, encountering so much traffic
Four
on
doors.
The road, still continues
it's
to just zip
Charger.
In and out of cars. And that officer very close as we get into more traffic here. And then here's where drivers can sometimes try to go the wrong way, but they are going to stay. And again, Gina, like I know you were talking about, there is definitely smoke coming from one of those tire wells right there.
Yeah, and it looks too like the fleeing suspect is kicking up their speed compared to when we first started watching this pursuit slash chase. We have to be cautious about using that word chase. I know police don't like that word used in some instances, but it looks as though it's reaching that kind of category because of the speed they're using. Again, new policy in Houston is to back off if the person they're pursuing is not accused of a serious crime. Again, we have no information about what it is this person is considered to have done. This now at South Ritchie and Laurel Street, we're doing a good job there with our instructions at the top of your screen. They're telling you where they're going. But yeah, we're also not seeing, Eric, the traffic getting much lighter. It seems as though this chase or pursuit is continuing to be around a lot of other vehicles, putting a lot of other of our community members at risk.
Yeah, it's surprising they haven't hit more traffic in what we usually see here in the Houston area. But yeah, again, South Ritchie here, this is some of the new GPS technology that our Sky I-13 was outfitted with a few months back. But now it's open road for this chase suspect here as officers, at least that one, and the patrol cruiser stays pretty close to the rear end of that car as he comes up to another congested intersection. Ooh. And it could get dangerous. It starts running through red lights. Luckily, nobody trying to cross that intersection right now, but picking up more speed and actually leaving that officer again. But again,
you know, I was gonna say, Eric, I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say that we've covered hundreds of these here at this station or in our career, and never do you see a suspect get away once helicopters are above the vehicle. They are able to stay with the suspect when they've got eyes on them like this. So we only hope that no one's hurt, but the person just really doesn't get away when they've got eyes on them like this.
Oh yeah.
And of course right now we're talking about that new
oh, yeah?
policy. And I look at the officer trying to use one of those possible pit maneuvers to hit the back fender of the car. It looks like the officer decided not to go that route as he pulled up on the right side of that red or maroon Challenger right there. But
make a U-ey. Yep. Make a U-ey, bro. What you doing?
He could be pinned in right here, but it looks like they're not going to take that move that they had, appearing that they had right there.
You know what we could see in that turn, though? We could see how many other police vehicles, because we've been pretty tight on the suspect vehicle and that one officer car. But when we did the turnaround, we could see how many other.
It almost feels like he's going in circles.
That's what he's doing.
Three U-turns in the 5 minutes we've been following here.
And he could not take them.
Yeah, and there was really nowhere to go.
Go on a highway.
For all these U-turns that he's taking right now. But he's continued to having to lock up the brake lights right here because
he or she.
He or she, right. They are continuing to lock up the brake lights here. And they're going to go on a side street here. We've already seen them go through at a high speed through one of the strip malls there. But they're going to what appears to be a residential area right now. Not as many lights, picking up speed as well.
Looks like in that area, I see what appear to be warehouses. And we're certainly glad that this area is not, as you mentioned earlier, more populated, or that it's not the time of day when school buses are trying to get children home. But we still, nevertheless, are hoping that officers are able to bring this to a non-violent or not dangerous.
This is where my stomach gets tight, though. He's just speeding through all these side roads. You don't know when anybody's going to pull out on one of the side roads, not suspecting that a car is going to be coming at anywhere from 60 to 80 miles an hour.
Can you tell for us, Tammy, how fast the vehicle is traveling? I know sometimes we're able to assess that with the technology there in the chopper.
Yeah, actually, I do have a speedometer. It's a little hard to keep up. My pilot, Parker Ward, doing an excellent job up here because we do have another police helicopter up here. So he's got to talk to air traffic control. And obviously, I am doing the camera as well as the Churchill. So again, the top of your screen, it's always usually pretty accurate, but sometimes the way I'm maneuvering the camera.
Ooh!
Now it looks like he is losing control of the vehicle. This is a Charger, so a very fast.
And that shit dusty too, boy.
The driver just thinks, you know, that this car can do excessive speeds, that they'll be able to get away from the police. But as you can see, there's so many police officers.
Oh, he finna hit the highway. He finna hit the highway.
Again, you do not see very many drivers.
Oh, now you know he hawking now for sure.
Starts.
All right, Tammy Rose, I tell you what, Gina and I are going to now hand it over to the 630 news team, Jonathan Bruce and Maida Moreno. They're going to take the police chase from here, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much, guys, for covering that.
Highway too busy, I guess.
Here to the news at 630. So we've been watching this, Jonathan, and just when we think it's coming to an end, he picks up speed and he loses officers behind, but they're still right on his tail, it seems.
Harrowing moments right now as we are watching live from Sky High 13. We picked this up about 6:26, Maida. So this has been nearly 10 minutes at this point, and we know the pursuit was happening well before that in terms of when we got to it, and a lot of different things. We've seen a smoking wheel, as Eric Barajas talked about. We've seen multiple U-turns. What we have not seen is this suspect or whoever's leading the police on this pursuit have any interest in stopping.
Yeah, and then honestly, when we see incidents like this, they rarely ever do stop. It's really hard to tell who is behind the wheel, still because the tint in this vehicle is completely dark. But again, we have had pursuits that involve women. So again, we don't know who is behind the wheel of this vehicle, but we're still following close. And it looks like police are probably trying to find him at a different part of this pursuit and hopefully block him in. I know there are instances where police try to get ahead and use those spike strips in hopes of stopping this person. But again, they're not stopping and they're continuing to go. So hopefully it doesn't turn into a pretty bad situation, because we have seen some pursuits lately that unfortunately turned deadly.
And we are watching live from Sky 13 right now. One thing that we are seeing here in real time is this vehicle is now back onto the freeway. It looks like the I-45 North Freeway right now. And Myra, the speed is increasing and accelerating to very, very fast levels as we see the vehicle going up this left shoulder right now.
Yes, and this should be the southeast side of town as it is going down 45 near Park Place and Broadway. Tammy, any other details or anything you have been able to gather since you first started following this pursuit?
Yeah, actually, police lost some near the Gulf Freeway, and as you saw, that Dodge Charger was maneuvering around an industrial area. But you know what? The police helicopter and Sky I-13 had their eyes right here on this driver making all these erratic turns and blowing through stop signs. And stuff. And there was smoke and fire.
Ooh. Now he done. Done.
But it looks like he crashed into another vehicle, police right behind him. Again, a Dodge Charger. Stopping here on the Gulf Freeway inbound near Park Place.
Yeah, it looks like he was trying to maneuver to, and he's and out. This person's out of the vehicle.
Oh, he got a dog in there too.
Yeah, this person is trying to.
Dangerous situation here on the feeder road of the Gulf.
Bro, what kind of wingman are you, bro? I thought it was man loves dog and dog loves man. How the hell you leave your dog behind, bro? What the. Why the hell you leave your dog behind, bro? Just walking on the freeway like that, bro. Your dog could have got freaking clipped by a car. Man, you are irresponsible, bro. You are very irresponsible.
Freeway, again, a foot pursuit. Police not that far behind him, along with a dog that is following him.
And we see the dog catching up there pretty quickly, and you feel like the dog will ultimately win that race. I don't know. I know that we have to have some discretion in terms of how close we can get, and it looks like the dog is extremely close, and maybe this suspect chase and, is behind the vehicles at this point. Myra, it looks like they're in water now at this point.
We did see some rain, obviously, yesterday, so I'm sure this area that he is trying to maneuver through, there's several puddles there, and it looks like he's trying to hide behind these vehicles. Hopefully, this person does not have some sort of weapon. Again, that is something that police have to take into account, because safety is first.
Boy, I'm not gonna cap. That's not gonna work, bro. That's not gonna work. The chopper on your ass, bro. Hiding ain't gonna work, folks. I tried that already, bro. With no chopper, so imagine.
Patrol, what is happening here? Again, in that vehicle in the center of our screen, we'll keep it kind of at a medium shot. Police have their guns drawn. And again, a dog, as well as a suspect, in the middle of our shot. The suspect inside the vehicle. Now it looks like he's actually given up. This is good. Back it up. This is what we like to see for an ending.
This is good. It looked like that suspect is backing up. They're currently placing handcuffs on him. And it just a crazy situation. I have never seen a pursuit where there is a dog involved following the suspect trying to get away from a scene.
And we believe, again, that it is actually the suspect's dog that had gotten out of the car with them and then followed. And all of this coming to an end right now. Timmy, where are you exactly off of the Gulf Freeway?
So we're in South Houston, east of the Gulf Freeway here, near Lynn Street and the Gulf Freeway. Again, one suspect in custody. It looks like they're trying to get the dog as well in a parking lot. He was actually hiding in one of these vehicles in this storage lot for vehicles.
This is quite a scene. Again, we have been following this pursuit since a little after the 6 o'clock newscast started, about 6:20-something or so before the 6:30 news started. And it first seemed as the suspect was not stopping, and it wasn't up until just a couple of a minute ago or so that this person crashed into two vehicles and then ditched the car, ran off, and then a dog followed right behind him.
We saw a lot of U-turns through residential neighborhoods and all kinds of maneuvers from the suspect. And the scene that you're looking at right now, Myra, we saw the suspect increase to extreme rates of speed, and then really it looked like crashed into the shoulder on the Gulf Freeway, and we saw sparks flying in every direction.
And you can see, as Tammy is showing us the situation here, the aftermath of this, how this pursuit ended. It looks like that is one of the vehicles that the suspect hit. Hopefully everybody that was involved is okay with everything else that happened. But again, now we're going to have some sort of backup here on 45 as police try to, of course, section off this area because it is now part of the investigation as they start to clean up where this suspect ditched his vehicle and took off.
If we can welcome Tammy back in now. Again, y'all are watching this live from Sky I-13 and our reporter Tammy Rose in the air. Tammy, how would you describe the way police and law enforcement went about this pursuit? We know that is always a question in these situations.
Yeah, I mean, they always can back off in these chases. Like, it looked like they did, or they even lost him, but it didn't matter because we had them as well as the police helicopter. But what's so scary is when the suspect got back on the Gulf Freeway and you saw it on live TV, hit an innocent bystander. Again, you're looking at the aftermath of that truck, a lot of damage. Only hoping and praying that nobody was hurt in this chase. Again, the suspect got out of his vehicle along with a dog, headed east of the Gulf Freeway, tried to hide in a vehicle, and police were able to nab him.
Tammy, can you tell if the other people that were hit are near their vehicle, if they seem okay or not? I know that is always a concern when other people get caught in this type of crazy pursuit.
Indeed, indeed.
Yeah, so far I'm just seeing tow trucks. I have not seen any ambulance. Well, actually, look at this. We got a couple of people, you know, probably obviously shell-shocked here from what happened. I mean, you're just driving in the Gulf Freeway. And again, you know, traffic is slow because there's so much traffic going inbound just south of downtown. So you're not expecting anybody to come up behind you at a high rate of speed. So again, we're still waiting for an ambulance, but what a scary situation because the suspect's vehicle, as you saw, caught fire. And it looked like just from the chase, it looked like, you know, the wheels, as we see, the tires get shredded down to the wheels.
Yeah, that truck up, bro. Like, he definitely messed that truck completely up. That's why the truck tire blew and everything, bro. He hit that shit so hard, sparks start to fly, bro. He probably blew the rear end on his car too, bro. That's crazy. That is crazy, folks. That is crazy. To me, interesting chase. Interesting chase. No one seemed to got seriously injured, so that's important. And yeah, maybe a little PTSD or something, but man, crazy, crazy, crazy. Hey, let me know what y'all think down below in the comment section, man. If you made it to this point of the video, you loyal. I f*** with you. I appreciate you big time. And with that being said, it's your boy Stacks Global, and I'm out. Peace.